Okay, the other most common question that I and I think most of the interviewers ask is, tell us something about your interests and hobbies. Interests and hobbies usually are unique, and most of us have unique interests and hobbies. And what is the difference between the two? Hobby is something which is active. So you can say that cricket is my interest, but you may not be playing cricket. While on the other hand, you can say that collecting stamps is my hobby. So hobbies, you have hobby is a kind of activity in which you basically are involved. Interest is more or less passive, right? So you can say that my interest areas are, you can have areas of interest. You can have areas of interest wherein you can say, yes, my interests are movies and sports, and it is broader in nature. So you can have many interests. But when you say hobby, that means it becomes a bit specific. And secondly, you devote time to it and you are actively involved in it. So one of your hobbies could be playing video games, or your hobby could be painting, right? So you're physically or actively involved, and that becomes hobby. You separate time for that. Your interest is something that makes you curious. You like to know more about it, and you do some kind of, you do follow things of that kind, and that is why it's your interest. Slight difference between the two, but yes, it definitely what happens when I get to know about your interest and hobbies, it tells me what kind of a person you are. Please understand. If you say that you are very fond of reading, it shows that, okay, fine, you must be having good command on your language. It shows that you might be having some knowledge about literature and writing, right? So most of us try to fake our interests and hobbies just to create a very good impression on the panelists. But my suggestion is, please don't do that, because the reason is, if there is any kind of cross questioning, then you would be caught in broad daylight. And therefore, if you don't have much interest and hobbies, you please don't speak about it. And if you have some kind of hobby, doesn't matter how weird it might look to you, you please speak about that, because something which you have already done will have a greater and more sincerity in the reply than something which you haven't done. So please avoid faking things. Why? Because if you start faking things, that means that you are an insincere person. And I think that would become I think it's quite objectionable, and I would not like to select a candidate who fakes his interests and hobbies. So if your hobby is something as simple as gardening, you please don't refrain from speaking about it. It's a very good thing, because it might sound silly to you, but any kind of activity which you follow passionately and you are fond of can become your hobby, and never be ashamed of sharing it with the panelists, right? So that there are people whose hobby is singing and cooking, and there are people who have the hobby of going for long walks, there are people who have the hobby of, let's say, you know, playing video games, and you should not be ashamed about it, because it's quite possible that you might reveal some fascinating aspects of your personalities by sharing your interests and hobbies, right? Now let's look at these points here. I believe that this is it's a question, if answered well, can overwhelmingly impress the interviewers. Why overwhelmingly? Because eventually, when you get a chance to speak something about yourself and something which is so unique as interest and hobby, you can speak about it in such detail that you can actually end up impressing the panelists. You can answer such questions well only if you indeed have some very good interest and hobby, something for which you really spend time. So many a time people come and ask me, sir, what should I fill in my hobbies and interests? You shouldn't ask such questions. If you have the silliest of hobby, you please put it there. If your hobby is to read the menu cards of restaurant, you please mention that, because again, that is an interesting thing. I might ask you, why do you like to read menu card of the restaurant? And then you might say, sir, the fascinating names they come up with. Right? So you can always have some very, very good observation from the most mundane things. And please don't refrain from sharing that with the panelists, right? He who does not have a hobby lacks luster and color. Please understand this. You must, many a time people have the hobby, but they think it's not a good hobby, so I would not mention it. I would mention something else. Just because you are going to a B school for an interview doesn't mean that you have to show that you read anything and everything around business. Please again, don't try to fake. He who does not have a hobby lacks luster and color, and he who is not able to speak well about his hobbies is either poor in language or is incapable of devoting his heart and soul to even those things that he apparently seems to like. What do we mean by this? It means that if you say that your hobby is painting, and then I ask you, okay, fine, can you just sketch something here? Or can you just paint this? Or can you just, you know, put something on paper here with your pencil? And if you're not able to do that, that means basically you just said for the sake of saying. If you say that your hobby is singing, and I ask you to sing a good song, and if you really are not able to do that, means basically you have just lied to the panelists. So please understand that when you are asked about your hobbies and interests, no matter how silly it looks to you, you please don't refrain from sharing it with the panelists. Because it might sound silly and unimportant to you, but it could be very, very interesting and entertaining for your listeners who are sitting there on the other side of the table. And what is a good hobby or interest? There is nothing called as good hobby or interest. It is just something that you do for pastime. So your interest could be reading about the private lives of film stars, no problem. So I would ask you, okay, tell me something about the private life of a particular film star. And if you really can answer that well, that shows that yes, you are genuine and you replied very honestly. So please understand that there is no good hobby or interest. You have a hobby, you have an interest, and if you have it, you must be able to speak about it. That's it, full stop, nothing more than that.